Hi, I'm Dr. Nemechek, the inventor of the Nemechek protocol, and I want to talk to you a little bit about the use of inulin versus rifaximin, or otherwise known as xifaxin in the United States, for the reversal of bacterial overgrowth. So many of you are familiar with my kind of conceptualization of bacterial overgrowth. We understand that the bacteria in the colon are very different fundamentally than the ones in the small intestine. And furthermore, the concentration is very different. So for every one bacteria by the stomach, you have 100 million bacteria at the end of the colon. And I've nominally just called these bacteria the ones in the upper intestinal tract birds and the one in the colon fish. Okay. And so you have very different bacteria up here, very small numbers, very high numbers of different bacteria down here. So, inulin versus rifaximin. All right, inulin, what that does is that it's, think of it as bird food, the bacteria that normally live up here, because with bacterial overgrowth, you have the fish bacteria living up here, and now you have like 100,000 times the bacteria. Inulin feeds the natural bacteria up here predominantly, all right? They produce acids. These fish bacteria don't like the acids, and through this fermentation effect, they regress. And so you get this separation of the bacteria back more towards normal. Now, in an adult, this can help your intestinal symptoms some. It might even make you feel a little bit better. But in the focus of my work has been on trying to reverse chronic autonomic damage. And inulin is incapable of giving me enough of an effect there to actually get the brain better. You can feel a little better, but it's not enough to help me get chronic brain injury to recover, okay? I have to use rifaximin for that case, and I'll talk about that in a minute. In children under 10, roughly, inulin does a great job, and it is enough to get the brain to start to recover. Now, then between 10 and 20 or so years of age, it kind of shifts from the need of inulin to rifaximin. And why is this? I just don't know. That's the honest answer. But on a practical level, now if I have a kid, say, who's 14 on inulin and they're recovering very nicely and doing well, I'll leave them on there, knowing though it's gonna quit working, you know, at some point in time, all right? And then we'll eventually have to use rifaximin. So inulin is best in kids under 10, variable effect between 10 and 20, and then over 20 doesn't work. We have to use rifaximin. Now, what's rifaximin? Rifaximin is a special antibiotic. It's a very unique one. It's not like all the other ones that kind of damage the gut, all right? Rifaximin's been around for about 30 years. We've used it for predominantly for a liver condition called hepatic encephalopathy. And interestingly, this is where you have the fish living up where the birds in an adult with cirrhosis of the liver. And there they produce a lot of ammonia, and it makes people confused, which is a parallel to autism, where you have the fish living where the birds are, and they make a different chemical called propionic acid. All right, so there's some parallels here. So we've used rifaximin around the world for about 30 years. Most of the adults who take it for this condition have to take it twice a day all year long, alrighty. And the way this drug works is it has a couple features. One, you don't absorb any in the bloodstream, all right, which is good. Very, you know, it limits side effects. Two, it's only effective in the small intestine because of these things called bile salts. And the bile salts are absorbed before they get to the colon, so the drug quits working in the colon. So the drug is only effective in the small intestine, and it doesn't get in the bloodstream at all. Three, it doesn't harm the natural, you know, bird bacteria that normally live within the small intestine. And four, it only is targeted at the bacteria in the colon. But I just said it doesn't work in the colon, it only works in the small intestine. So in other words, those fish bacteria that normally belong in the colon will only be affected if they're up here, which is what we're trying to get rid of, all right? So, and the rifaximin, you only have to take twice a day for 10 days. You don't have to take it year-round. Twice a day for 10 days, you sweep the fish bacteria out, you leave the bird bacteria behind, voila, you're done. It is much more effective than most people think. One of the reasons is a lot of people think, oh, I took my Rifaximin and I've still got some bloating and some constipation. Well, those are actually autonomic symptoms, brain symptoms, not bacterial overgrowth symptoms. So it's a different issue. Now, what about, why not use Rifaximin, because it sounds stronger, you know, it's a medicine and all this kind of stuff. Why don't we use those in kids? Well, the advantage of Inulin over Rifaximin is that the Inulin is much more durable if, say, a child needs some antibiotics for an ear infection, all right? Because you're taking it every day. It helps maintain the separation. If you use Rifaximin, if you have to use Rifaximin because you're just old enough or you didn't get the response out of Inulin, all right, there's nothing maintaining that. And now a course of antibiotics, for instance, has the potential to cause relapse to happen again, where you get bacterial overgrowth again and you would have to retreat. Now, that's not that big of a deal, but if you can get away just with Inulin, you don't even have to worry about it, all right? Now, what about other fibers? I don't know, there may be other fibers out there. I'm a very practical guy. The Inulin works great, all right? It's cheap, it's readily available, so just stick with the Inulin. Don't try to finesse it and coming up with some other stuff. Just keep the life, your life pretty simple. So, kids under 10, Inulin's the way to go. 20 years and older, you pretty much gotta use Rifaximin if you wanna get any degree of neurological recovery. And between 10 and 20, it's kind of a variable transition. And you know, you can try Inulin, start there, and then if you get a response, stay with it. If you don't get a response, you step up to the Rifaximin, all right? So this is Dr. Patrick Nemechek of Nemechek Autonomic Medicine in Buckeye, Arizona. Hope you found this useful. Bye.